Now the next question is what are the mantissa and exponent required respectively to represent 5 in binary floating point representation? So let's start with the solution. So this is the solution. So 5 can be written as 10 by 2, but it is not a binary floating point representation. Or you can written as 20 by 4, or you can written as 40 by 8. Okay, but these are not the binary point representation, because in binary point representation the number should be in points. Okay, so the smallest one will be what it will be to represent the 5. It can be like this if you want to do it in point form. So 5 can be 5 can be represented as this 5 can be represented as 2.5 multiplied with 2. Okay, or 1.25 multiplied with 2 again, or 0.625 multiplied with 8. Okay, so basically this is the binary representation, floating point binary representation. Rest are not the floating point binary representation. Okay, so we will take this one, because this 5 can be represented as 10 by 2, 20 by 4, 40 by 8, but these are not the binary point floating point representation. Similarly, 2.5, okay, we are talking about 5 is equals to 5 can be represented as 2.5 multiplied with 2, or 1.25 multiplied with 2. So these are also not the binary floating point representation, but this one is the floating point representation. Okay, so now we will start doing this one. So take binary floating point representation. So this is our floating point representation, 0.06625 multiplied with 8. Okay, now you need to convert it in binary form. So 8 can be, if you want to modify it, make it, okay, just take one arrow for this one. Okay, so what it will be, 0.625, now I am writing it in binary, okay, 2 to the power 3, okay, in binary, in, okay. Now we need to convert it 0.625 in binary. Okay, so how to convert this 0.625 in binary? Let me tell you. Yeah. So here you can see 0.625. Now you need to multiply it with 2. Okay, so just multiply with it 2. So it will become 1.250. Okay, so for this one you got the, sorry, just take a straight line. Okay, so this will represent 0.1. okay, 0.1. now what you will do, just leave the one, this 0.1, now take only 0.25. okay, so here 0.25. okay, 0.25 multiplied with 2 again. Now what you will get, 0.50. okay, so no before point, nothing is there, so you can write here only 0. okay, so next bit of the this conversion will be 0.1, you already got. Now you will add 0. okay, again you multiply this 0.5, again this you multiply with this 0.5, 0.50 multiplied with 2, so you will get how much, 1.0. okay, so next number in your conversion will be 0.101. okay, so this is your conversion. If you talk about 0.625, 0.625, 5, okay, in binary. So in binary it will be, in binary it will become 0.101. okay guys, now you can see here we were using this representation. So 0.101 you converted it, and binary floating point representation can be in octal or hexagonal. Okay, so in octal each bit should be represented in 3 bits. Okay, so 0.625 can be represented like this, 0.101 and add 3 zeros. Okay, and multiplied with 2 to the power 0, 1, 1. Okay, so this is your mantissa and this is your exponent. So your number was 5, and for floating point representation it was 0 point, you can write it like 0.65 into 2 to the power 3. Okay, 2 to the power 3, like this. Okay, so now you need to convert it. Yeah, you already converted it in binary form, so that was, you already converted it, 0.101. okay, for octal make it 6 bit, means basically we are writing it in 0.2 points. Okay, suppose it is basically it is 0.50, so in octal 5 can be represented as 101, 3 bit, and 0 can be represented as 000, like this we are representing. Okay, into 2 to the power 3 can be written as 11. So in binary you can write it 0, 1, and 1. Okay, so this will become your mantissa and this is your exponent. Okay, so the final answer will be 0.101000, and exponent will be 011. We are representing in 3 bits because it's an octal. If you representing your floating point representation in hexa, then you will take 0001, 4 bits. Okay.